Epilepsy is 83 meters per second at about 2.6 kilometers from the surface of Mars. We have confirmation that the back shell has separated. We are currently performing the divert maneuver. Current velocity is about 75 meters per second at an altitude of about a kilometer off the surface of Mars.
Here in Safety Bravo.
We have completed our terrain relative navigation. Current speed is about 30 meters per second, altitude of about 300 meters off the surface of Mars. We have started our constant velocity accordion, which means we are conducting the sky crane, about to conduct the sky crane maneuver.
We've lost direct to earth tones.
As expected. As expected.
Sky crane maneuver has started. About 20 meters off the surface.
We're getting signals from MRO.
Your surface good?
Touchdown confirmed. Perseverance safely on the surface of Mars, ready to begin seeking the sands of past life. At this point, the descent stage has flown away to a safe distance. Perseverance is continuing to transmit direct through Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter to Earth.
Reports they're still getting telemetry from the lander.
All right, all stations.
We got it.
Touchdown confirmed. We're going to wait for the images.
Wow. This is so exciting. The team is beside themselves. It's so surreal. Stay tuned. We might get some pictures.
Yeah, we just heard the news.
All right, so touchdown, Ron. Nothing makes me happier than some fist bumping NASA scientists at the Jet Propulsion Lab there in Pasadena. So score one for them. Before I hear from you, I just want to tell our viewers. So what we were watching is the animation, right? So it was impossible for NASA to see actual live video of this Perseverance rover touching down on the red planet, but we will get those pictures. They will get those pictures tomorrow. Ron, oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
Amazing. Amazing. Think about what we just witnessed. That spacecraft traveled 300 million miles. It hit the top of the atmosphere of the Martian atmosphere at 12,000 miles per hour, went through that 7 minutes of terror, and it did that all automatically because it takes 11 minutes for a signal to reach the Earth from Mars, and so all that has to be done automatically.
Talk about, so you saw on that animation map, the crater, it's called the, I don't know if I'm saying this correctly, Jezero crater. This is where this rover is headed, right? Because it's all about figuring out signs of life from billions of years ago.
Yeah, this is an ancient, it's a crater, but it used to be a lake, right? And so there's going to be areas there that are the prime places to look for life. And I think, imagine if we see evidence that there was once life on Mars. I mean, that would be amazing in itself. But to me, the other part of that is we'd want to know why there's not life there now. We'd want to know why a planet that used to have water and used to potentially be able to support life no longer does. And that has incredible implications for our own climate study here on Earth.
Last question for you, Ron. Just, you know, as an astronaut, as someone who's obviously studied space for and all of it for years and years, for our viewers at home, why is this truly spectacular? What will this mean for the U.S. moving forward in terms of space discovery?
I think it's these are the baby steps of exploring our whole solar system, and really everything we do in space directly benefits life on Earth. It directly benefits our ability to survive all the crises that might come at us, whether that's supervolcano eruptions, global warming, whatever the case is. A better understanding of how planetary science works, how planets function, and the life cycle of planets is going to help us here on Earth immensely. And it's also going to help us understand our place in the universe.
For sure. We'll get all those pictures tomorrow and continue, chewing on all of this touchdown. I love it. Thanks for sharing that moment with me, Ron. I really, really appreciate you.
You bet, Brooke.
And thank you all for being with me. I'm Brooke.